Hello students, welcome to the class of Editorial Decode, and in this class I will be decoding Bridging Ties with New Silk Road, written by Srinivasan Ramani. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in General Studies Mains Examination Paper 2. Plus this is very important for Political Science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how China is trying to create alternative structures in the sphere of economy, in the sphere of trade, and in the sphere of diplomacy. Alternatives for the ones that were created in the past by the Western countries. This editorial is also about how China is trying to metamorphose its image from being a belligerent country to a soft country. This editorial is also about the response that India should be giving to the projects which China is coming up with. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to understand the philosophy behind the Silk Maritime Trade Route and also the philosophy behind the New Silk Road, because that will give us an idea about the nature and the scope of the projects being followed by China. Now, as far as the Silk Maritime Trade Route is concerned, it was conceptualized by China so that it could protect, it could secure the maritime trade routes, because maximum trade for China is being conducted through the sea lanes, and China wants to protect all these sea lanes from the menace of piracy. China also wants to wield diplomatic influence over the countries that are lying in the vicinity of the Pacific Ocean and the Indian Ocean. So this is the philosophy. It contains the message of wielding the diplomatic power and strengthening it security wise. Now, what is the philosophy behind this New Silk Road? Now, as far as the Silk Road that has been proposed by China, it has been proposed or it is ongoing because of three substantive reasons. If you look at the China's economic development and the progress, you will find that the southern part of the China, it is less developed. There is a disparity existing in China. Kuch hisse jo China ke bahut zyada tarakki kar gaye hain, kuch hisse aise hain China ke jinme abhi tarakki nahi hui hai. And in order to develop those regions, China, it has come out with this project New Silk Road route, because this will help it to strengthen the southern regions. So this is part one of the philosophy behind this. Creating this route will help China to inculcate, to percolate prosperity and development in the regions which had been lagging behind in the race of development. And the second thing, the second reason why China has come out with this project is that it wants to wield the economic power over the entire South Asian, East Asian and West Asian region. And this project, it contains the message of economic prosperity for the entire region. And this message, this aim, this goal is actually opposite to what China was following 2 to 3 years back. 2 to 3 years back, China was following a belligerent policy, and it's because of this belligerency, it had estranged its relationships with Laos, Cambodia, Vietnam, Philippines, Indonesia, and even with Japan. Now it wants to bring about a transformation. It wants to bring about a change. It wants to metamorphose its own image from belligerency to being a soft state. So, because of that, this New Silk Road, it contains a message of economic integration, it contains a message of the holistic economic prosperity for the entire Asian region. And by doing this, China also wants to act as a godfather for the entire region. Because if you look at the scale of these projects, if you look at the scope of these projects, they are actually very huge. They are all encompassive. These projects, they are trying to integrate the disparate economies, the capitalist economies. It is trying to integrate the disparate cultures, the cultures, Muslim cultures, with the complete capitalist cultures of Japan, and with the socialistic culture and the economic setup of India. Now the question comes, should India be joining these projects or not? As far as the UPA government was concerned, it was very tardy, it was very slow, and it had procrastinated on this decision of whether it should be joining or it should not be joining. Now if you look at the third aspect of these projects, they certainly have a strategic tinge behind them. They have a message that the China wants to act as a superpower. It wants to wield, it wants to hegemonize the entire Asian region. And India is actually wary of this, because we have already seen the belligerency of China in the war with China in 1961. India don't want the same repetition. So because of that, the India's approach, India's response is very reticent, it is very calculative, it is very slow. And before it responds to the call of China, it wants a response, a positive response from China on the main issue of boundary conflict. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to avail the information about the classes that we are offering, you can visit our website, that is eiasmentors.com and brainyki.com. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainyki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.